Okay, you've made it past the first round. Not too shabby. I'm sure Mr. Vitale will agree there's still plenty of games left to play, and one of them is this second round game between the Texas Longhorns and the Wisconsin Badgers.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Badgers are prepared to fight tooth and nail in this one, Dick. What are the keys to victory?
If I'm their coach, the keys would be these. Number one, don't let the other team dictate the tempo and the pace. Play at your speed, baby. Next, challenge every shot from the perimeter. Get right up in their faces, baby. Thirdly, grab the boards, baby. Make it a habit.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. Off the rim and no good. The center gets the pass. He fakes the shot and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. There's the pick. There's the roll. And he scores despite the hack. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Jumps into the defender. Waters makes the finger roll.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots from the baseline. Drains it. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. And a momentary look from three-point land. Nice steal there, but the offense gets the ball back. Jumps in. The Badgers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Daddy's on fire.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul, Dick.
He's out of control, baby, out of control. Trying to go inside.
King is pretty fired up and excited.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
The Badgers go to the line for the first time in this game. Gets the first. Gets two at the charity stripe. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. The point guard takes the feed.
Look at that spacing.
Fakes it. 10 seconds to get a shot off. He buries the shot.
Hey, one basket, Brad. If they can get some points here, the crowd will be extremely happy.
Goes up for two, and he scores it off the glass. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. The shooting guard takes the pass.
Nice job of using the screen to get open for that good shot.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. There's a high screen. They look to get it to the inside. He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
in the paint. He up fakes. For two, and off the mark. On the outside, he lets it fly. Perfectly designed, perfectly executed, easy basket. Two for one opportunity. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Dumps it in. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
The center gets the ball. For the bucket.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
And the ball goes out of play. This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat.
Tries for two. Doesn't go. Launches it. No good. And the ball goes out of bounds. At the half, the Badgers lead by three. Let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. Texas carelessly gave away a lot of possessions by turning the ball over.
Their coaching staff must be livid right now. The amount of extra opportunities they're giving away is just absurd.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron.
We'll get a better look on the replay.
Trying to feed inside.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. In and out.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Turnaround jumper, and he missed. He'll go to the line after that vicious dunk, Dick.
Vicious is right, Brad. That dunk brought me right out of my seat, baby.
He goes to the free throw line. He buries it.
Yeah, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking out of box.
Off the rim and no good.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
Rims out. Waters fakes the shot, and he'll kick it back outside. Picked off. Well, that's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job by the defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
That comes off. Might have been some contact on the shot. Can't get it to go. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Off the rim and no good. The point guard takes the pass. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Defensively, low block. Running him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity. And it really converts an offensive transition.
They're working around the arc. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression. Pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Looking for a good shot. Looking for a good shot. Moving it around the perimeter. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do.
You really need to protect the ball around these guys. High-post screen, so effective that screen.
He gets the board.
Pressure on the ball, head on the ball.
Jackson is fired up and ready to go.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
Off target. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Makes an outstanding block.
There's the trap.
He shoots from the top of the circle. Rims out. With the fake. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
The Badgers have a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
Reese handles the feed, controlling the ball. Wow, Nick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
Out with a foul.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ball game. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And yet another foul. Nick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
There's the turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in a game at the end drops significantly.
Second shot, good.
Gotta get one in this possession, baby.
Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
I think she's right about that, Richie. Just about ready for play to resume.
A 5-point lead could go either way with this much time, Brad.
Oh, it certainly can, Dick. They work the perimeter. The shooting guard handles the pass.
Better foul quick.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. With the free throw. makes the front end of the 1-1. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Makes the second. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. The lead trickles down to four.
Time is either your best friend or your worst enemy at this point, Brad.
Spencer receives the ball. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on, one team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball, they made sure they converted on the free throw line, they did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Is on their way to the Sweet 16 now after dispatching both their first two foes.
I'll tell you, Brad, these young men are bringing their A game, and their third round opponents better be prepared because these kids are looking to go all the way, baby.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.